Hey everybody, we're here.
We're on the boat.
We're on the boat. We just boarded the old ferry here. Usually the ferry stops at a bunch of different islands, and
so you heard that first line was going to be on.
For some reason, this one's going straight to our destination. We don't have any stops, which is pretty nice. So, heading out to the island. It is Friday. It's Friday morning.
Yeah.
7:45 right now. Taking off. What a nice morning. It's like 70 degrees out here, maybe a little warmer. It's so nice. Love it. And that is what Pam calls the world's largest chia pet.
Yes. That's how I know we're getting closer to the island.
It's an old fort from the World War. It used to have cannons out of it.
Which they converted into something peaceful like chia pets.
Yeah, there's like trees growing on top of it now. It's kind of cool, but yep. It never fired a shot. They never shot anything in that thing. It was just there for precautionary, apparently. But pretty cool, anyway. Pretty cool.
We should go there one day.
I know.
Can we?
I think you can go out there. I don't know how, though.
I want to give them, like, fertilizer.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if you guys can see over there. That's actually a shipwreck. So this is Great Diamond Island right here. This is the island we're actually getting married on. But there's two different ports, or there's two different sides of the island. One side is a old military like base that they converted into a community, which is where we're going. And this side is more like just regular residential housing and stuff. So we're skipping that stop. And then the next stop will be our stop. So pretty cool, pretty cool. Like these are all, that's another island there, and there's like tons more way out there. There's lots of islands out here. It's pretty awesome. I've been on that one over there, obviously this one, and that's about it. I haven't been on any other of the islands out here, really.
You were a wee lad in pop.
Yeah.
Biking across the terrain.
Here's our stop, right in there. Where we're going. Diamond Cove, Great Diamond Island, Maine.
Are you ready to go?
Yep.
I'm Becky.
There they are.
Is that
not
Becky?
Yep. Hello.
Start throwing things to pop. There he is.
This is the camera.
I was wondering.
This is it. Right there. Say hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hi. Get out of my
face. Say hello.
What are you yacht sailing?
Yeah. So we're having dinner here.
Show them out there.
Out there? Oh, yeah. Okay. I'll show them. This is the restaurant. This is the restaurant on the island.
This is not.
And I'll show you guys the views. Check it out. So we're heading back to Portland right now. It's Friday, right? Is it Friday?
I don't. I'm on vacation.
I lost track of the days.
Don't forget the Pinot.
I won't forget. I gotta get some wine, Pinot Grigio. We're heading back to Portland to get some things that we left there because we couldn't carry them out this morning. And then we're getting some. Heading to the store to get some other odds and ends that we need for the wedding, so that's what we're doing. We're waiting for the ferry to come in to catch it back to Portland. What?
She was asking if you were really coming in the stream of life.
Yeah, no, I'm really. Yeah, it cuts out.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so we're back in Portland here, and we got everything that we need.
I got ice cream.
Some
this
ice
is
cream.
Literally full of ice cream.
We got the last odds and ends that we need to get.
police officer. Hello.
Oh, look at this.
Whoa.
That's crazy.
It is crazy. Anyway. So, we're actually not going to take a ferry back this time. We're going to take a water taxi.
We're going to be VIP.
VIP. For one, it's quicker. And plus, it's easier. Oh, no, we forgot something.
What?
The mirror.
Oh.
He's still over there.
All right. Go get the mirror.
All right, so we got the mirror. Pam needs a full-length mirror. It was in my truck. Almost forgot it.
I like to watch myself in full-length when I eat. That's why I want it.
We're here on this little dock. We're going to be getting a water taxi instead of taking a ferry. So, a little bit difference.
You're going to have to take your hat off.
Yeah, we'll be going fast. A lot faster than the ferry, right?
How long does it take to go?
It's like 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
It's not far. So, just waiting for them to come pick us up. It amazes me how they can park these ferries. It's crazy. They parallel park them like nothing. It's like, I would be smashing everything in my way if I tried to do that. It's just nuts. Boarded water taxi.
Yeah. And then we found
unexpected family.
Family
showed up.
Bonus!
Yeah. Say hi.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, I got a buzz on.
What?
He said hi, I got a buzz on.
Expecting more.
Here we go.
Wave to all our fans. Hi, we love you.
We love you.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Portland.
And you.
Goodbye.
You. I love you all. We will return.
Mañana.
Unknown date.
Probably Monday, right? Yeah. Probably Monday.
Well, us.
Yeah, you guys are going back.
Yeah.
Sunday, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah, it's kind of the work Monday thing.
Yeah. Yeah, the work thing.
That's a horrible habit.
I love you, man.
Bye. Bye.
We could stay on Monday.
Bye. Let's go.
Did you bring more batteries?
So we were standing on the dock to get on the water taxi.
Yes.
We're standing there and then all of a sudden we hear, "Hey Ryan and Pam!" And they're running to go get the ferry. And I'm like, "The ferry already left." So
they wait for Noah.
So they're riding
Thank
with
you,
us.
Ryan.
You're welcome.
You're my hero.
You're welcome.
I don't care what Dave says about
it. Hello! Look at that ship. Wow.
That is the
Celebrity Summit, it says. Does that mean there's celebrities on board?
One day. Maybe Lonnie's on there. Lonnie and John.
That is a huge ship.
And Justin.
For more.
Yeah, here we are.
Oh yeah, by the way, there's no cars on this island and it's only golf carts, so this is how we drive around out here.
Electric
Woo-hoo. Golf carts, no engines, correct. So lots of fun.
everybody. My name's Ashley, and today on Diamond Cove News, we will be talking about nail polish.
Oh my. I thought this was about Ryan and Pam's wedding.
He gave me the camera, so it's about me.
Saturday.
Saturday. What time is it?
A little after 10.
A little after 10.
People coming in.
Woohoo!
On the boat, I'm gonna go meet him.
I gotta get my shoes on.
You can get your shoes on.
All right, we'll check back in.
Okay, bye.
They get here before the storm do. I saw Ashley check for me. She said that there's storms gonna come at. Wait, you're not Ashley. I'm just used to looking at him when I don't know what else to say.
At 1 p.m.
1 p.m.
It was like a 60% chance.
Well, I don't know if we'll be able to go in the ocean.
Yeah.
But I'm hoping, because apparently that weekend when you guys went away, it was like, it said it was going to thunderstorm and it was fine.
Yeah, yeah. Remember?
Yeah.
And so far, I don't see clouds.
Yep.
So we'll see. I'm gorgeous!
Hey, puppy.
Your dad, maybe. Hopefully.
My dad.
Ryan, Pam.
It's your wedding weekend, and it's emotional.
And we're so happy for you guys.
We love
you guys. You'll see this video later on, but we wish you guys the best. We love you guys.
You're better at talking than I am.
Well, we talked about saying this, but we want you to see this later on. So, congrats, guys.
Yay!
So,
do you
want to
lead
these through the stairs again, or just want to gather in the corner?
Hi.
Yeah.
Same time.
All right, let's go.
You can come and just kind of stand right in line after him, because then I'm gonna try to just stay here so I can see the girls.
Right.
But if you step in, pause. Aaron's about halfway down the aisle, and then you can go. Bam. Stop and pause. Okay. So then I would go ahead and start. Yep.
The guests are gonna rise. You're gonna come down the stairs.
There it is.
Yeah.
Tie it already?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. There he is.
D's nuts.
What does Pops think, anyways?
Bradford.
Sugar, sugar, doom, 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 doom.
We're going to the beach okay. Now. And they're going to come up. Pops is going to drive Steve there.
Good.
No, it's not.
We got today. I'm like, I don't think we're supposed to go that way. And so I sent him another. La, 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 la. Get dad.
It's coming in. There it is.
We made it.
Which way did you come down?
We just
went by the
what do you think?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
And we went on the thing.
Yep.
Sorry, I didn't know
you were on. That was okay. Uh-oh, looks like a thundercloud.
Isn't that supposed to be good luck?
What do you think, Pam?
I think it better just get done what it's doing now.
T-minus 23 hours till a wedding.
Really?
Probably.
Did you do that count?
Could be.
Oh my gosh.
Uh-oh.
I can't wait for it to be done.
Getting there. Just think, you'll look back 50 years from now and be like, wow.
I'll be like, what the
that
heck?
That was so long ago. I don't even remember it.
I'm going to say
who
that.
Who's that guy filming with the GoPro?
I'm
going to say who's that guy filming with? With the GoPro, I can't even remember him.
That's because you'll be married to Ashley by then, and
I know.
Have a couple kids of your own.
A couple. Just a couple. Dinner time! Woo!
Dinner.
We have some nut plates in there.
Some nuts.
So the wine in the cup.
Might get rained out. Hello.
For this day, I thank you for Ryan and Pam as they begin their journey in life together. Lord, I just thank you so much for a beautiful day, beautiful weather, a beautiful couple, an amazing family that you have here that you brought all together, Lord. Father, I just pray that all your blessings will be upon them as they begin this walk with you, Lord, and that the next day and next couple days will be just beautiful days, and that you'll just make everything go smooth, that the peace that you have, Lord God, will just be over everything that happens. Father God, we just honor you. We give you glory and praise right now. We thank you for all that you've done and all that you're doing and all that you're going to do in this new life together. Father, we just thank you for asking to bless your, have your blessing upon this food that we're about to eat, and we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, yeah.
Crash. Oh! And there's the rain. Here it comes, right here. What you got, bud?
Got some mussels.
All right.
Some cool. Good mussels.
What are you eating, Pam?
I'm eating mussels and patootie.
Nice. What is that? What's a patootie?
I think it's crispy bread. I'm
really?
Like fancy crispy
interesting.
Bread.
It's like garlic bread.
Oh, it's it. I thought the garlic was in there.
Did you just go pick those out of the ocean just now?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, Ryan.
Those just come right out of the ocean.
They're fresh out of the ocean.
Fresh out of the ocean,
yeah.
Dude.
They're not even close.
Nice.
Yep.
See what everybody else has got. Hey, what you eating? What are you eating?
I don't know.
You don't know? It's good. It's good though. Right?
Yeah.
Hitting the spot.
I'll just sleep.
Appetizer.
All right. What do you got? What is that? A bird?
Tuna.
Dead bird?
It's tuna.
This is the tuna.
Picked that off the parking lot.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Nice.
just walking down the street. You
know, a little salad action. I like that. Nothing but wine over on this end.
Exactly.
Woohoo! What'd you eat, Nash?
Bucatini pasta.
All right. What are you having?
Shrimp.
Black and shrimp.
What's that, a swordfish?
Oh.
What are you having, a swordfish?
Tuna.
What's the bride and groom having for entrees here?
I'm having lobster snappy.
Nice.
Yep.
Is that a favorite?
One of your favorite.
Yeah,
it wouldn't be Maine without it.
Yeah, no
kidding. You know, it wouldn't be Maine without it.
Would you have?
Salad.
Salad, all right.
Salad.
No bread. No carbs today.
No.
And Pam, is this Pam right here?
Yeah, that's Pam.
What'd she have?
Lined up.
She got a shrimp cocktail.
All right.
And then I think she got
clam chowder.
Like,
yeah,
salad.
Nice. Awesome. Oh, really? What are you having? Same thing as Ryan?
Oh, yeah.
Sweet.
We watched them yesterday.
I like it. What are you having?
I got tuna.
Tuna?
Tuna.
No
amazing.
Kidding. Yeah, he got tuna down
it's
there.
It's amazing.
John had too, yeah.
Yep.
What's Bob having? Bob, what do you have? What is that? Spaghetti?
I got, it was,
no. In Italian.
Lobster.
Linguini?
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's lobster linguine.
Scampi, yeah.
Scampi looks like.
Lobster scampi.
Looks like
thank
someone's
you.
Brain.
Yeah, it like does, brain. Don't it? That's yeah. Why I like this pasta.
Yeah, all right. Got all kinds of good stuff over on this side. That's what Ashley got. What is that?
The bucatini.
Bucatini. That's what Ashley got.
With these scallops.
Nice.
Mighty
cool.
Mighty. Mighty.
I see another one. I see 2, 3, 4 of those. Nice. You'll be on the thrifting channel. Chicken. That ain't chicken. Chicken's not green. All right.
Where are we going now?
We are going to do the something with the chandeliers, I think.
Okay.
Is what I heard. We just had dinner.
Yep.
We're doing good. We're matching. We got
we
the
are.
Red.
Wait, ready?
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Yeah. So we're going to help Ryan and Pam and everybody do something with the chandeliers. And it might be a night out on the island. Who knows?
We'll oh, it see. Will. We will make
I'm
it a
I'm not
night
holding
out.
Anything back. We're gonna have fun.
Right?
So.
Here
oh,
we go.
I see your parents.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Who's that coming down the trail? D's Nuts? D's Nuts is here?
Got
since
him.
When?
That's a great idea.
What's going on, guys? What are you doing?
Playing some decorations.
I've had 3 or 4 costume changes today. Pardon what?
A ladder.
A ladder.
Find one.
All right.
We can put it through.
Okay, let's go to the tent.
Do you two want
to
go to the tent?
What are you doing, Ryan?
Right now we're hanging these chandeliers
nice.
That are half built. So we still have the lights have to go on. Those going on in the
yeah.
morning. But we're hanging them right now,
that's
getting
cool.
them ready.
That's wicked cool.
There's the techie boss. There's the second one right
all right.
Done.
That's a mistletoe, ain't it?
Yeah, come kiss me.
Yeah, no. No. I'm going to go get a bird's eye view. Hey, Pam. Pam Oema. All right, we are 1 hour away from go time. Let's do it. Everybody's getting ready. I'm getting the GoPro. We're gonna film this. It's gonna be awesome. What do you think? You ready? You all suited up?
Yep.
Ready to go?
I am ready.
Sweet. Nice. You got the rings, right?
Yep.
Got the rings?
All the rings.
You're supposed to have the rings. They didn't tell you?
No, I'm going to have to go back on the boat and get them.
Oh, no. Uh-oh. They're not getting married now. All right, things are good. 1:10. This is my video diary. I'm going to get ready. Things are good. We broke the tripod, but it's all right. It's not going to hinder the filming process. So, you can hold it. But I got to go get ready. So, I think everybody else is already ready. All right, let's
do it.
So everybody's having a good time having lunch. So
they want me to film everybody.
Hi, big so fella.
We got Betty. We got Betty number two.
What's my name? What's my name, buddy? Come on.
Mark and Mark two.
Hey.
Yep.
Sandra. Sandra.
You guys, ready to go? Ready to go.
Ready to go.
Yep. There's the ladies. Woohoo! There they are. Ooh, and the bride and the maid of honor. Everybody. All right. And everybody. There's the boys.
Real sharp.
Yeah. Dude, where'd you get it? There's the boys. There he is. Yo.
I was actually just coming back here,
yeah.
And I'm like, shit, I don't know where to go. I don't know what to do. So
yeah.
I looked up Express.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Remember, stagger.
Hey, stagger.
And the L shape.
Remember
the L shape.
Stag is important.
The L shape.
It's my friend Sarah. I don't know. She's good. She's actually really good. She's sweet to me. It's not the heavy one.
The ladies are up here.
We're up here.
Staying warm.
Oh, that's why we're
nice and toasty.
I know. It's Pam.
Ready to go.
Dad's all set. Here we go. Hi, Pam.
We just have to make sure.
Hello.
The ladies are all set.
Square looks good.
I think she's holding
looking
up.
Sharp.
Good
play.
Thank you.
Good?
Good.
Alright, cool.
Yeah, we can do pictures now. Oh, but he's hot.
Too late for him to
tell him.
Thank you.
Are you sure this is your chance to keep her if you want her? All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bow our heads in prayer real quick. Father God, we just praise you. We thank you for this day. God, we just thank you for beautiful sunshine, beautiful family, Lord God. We thank you for what you're doing here today. Father, bringing two people together and joining them together as one, Lord God, in your sight. Father, we just thank you. We praise you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. May you be seated. We just want to welcome all of you here for making the journey for land and sea to get this moment today. This is going to be an amazing time today. Join these two together as they begin the rest of their lives together. So we just want to welcome you today. So in Ecclesiastes, it talks about how two people are better than one. And that definitely is described with you guys. You two are an amazing couple. My wife and I have the opportunity to work with you guys and do premarital counseling with you guys, and it has been a joy to watch you guys as you've grown over the last few years, and the last year just knowing you and knowing you guys as a couple in church and watching you grow together spiritually and together in love. It's just been really amazing to watch you guys and to see your love grow. There's a peace that's in your life, the two of you. You guys both have this overwhelming peace and sense of calm within you. That I think even talking with people here, as I've met friends and family, they describe it the same way. That you guys just have this way about you, this peace, this tranquility that comes from both of you. And so I just think it's amazing watching you guys get to this day, take these steps to do what you're doing today, join your lives together. It's just amazing. There's no stress. There's no anxiety. There's just excitement, looking forward to what God has for your future. And I'm so excited for the two of you today. And in Ecclesiastes, talking about how two are better than one, it says this: as two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. That's not the case with you guys anymore. Now, you're a team. You're a team. You're going to be a team the rest of your lives. Are you guys ready? Do your vows? Couples that are out there. And if anybody's out there, you're a young couple, you're
dating or you're single, this should be a couple that you guys monitor right after. Yesterday, we had the opportunity to go out, and they asked if we could do a baptism before the wedding. So we did that yesterday at the rehearsal after we did the rehearsal. And, you know, I just think it's so unique and so special that we wanted to do that. Neither one of them had ever been baptized before, and they wanted to do it before they started their life together. They wanted to do it together, which I think is just incredibly unique. And, and for those of you that don't know, you know, baptism is just a symbol of what a 90-year-old self, and it's like I said, I was explaining to them yesterday, you know, there's nothing magical that happens. There's no fairy dust that is spread over you as you're coming up out of the water, but it's an outward sign of your commitment to God, of your giving your life to God, and the old person goes under the water, and the new person comes up, and you're a new creation. Today, you're even more new creation because you're starting your life together as one. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful thing. And again, I'm just so excited for you both. And I've loved walking through this journey with you and seeing how you guys have chosen to take your steps as you've done this. So, super proud of you guys. You ready to be in the house? Alright, so Ryan, with these vows that you guys are about to do, say to each other, this is saying to your spouse and to God that this is forever. So here we go. Ryan, with the eye of me. I acknowledge my love for you. To invite you to share my life, as I hope to share yours. I promise to walk by your side, to love, to help, and to encourage you. I vow to take time to share with you, to listen to you, and to care for you. I will share your laughter and your tears, as your lover and your friend. I promise to always respect you and to honor you as an individual. I will be conscious of your needs, and I shall seek through kindness and compassion to achieve with you the life that God's plan for us. And I promise to always be your teammate. Okay. Yeah, you mean. Ready? Take a deep breath. Ryan, I acknowledge my love for you. To invite you to share my life. As I hope to share yours. I promise to walk by your side. To love. To help. And to encourage you. I vow to take time to share with you, to listen to you, and to care for you. I will share your laughter and your tears as your lover and your friend. I promise always to respect you and to honor you as an individual. I will be conscious of your needs. And I shall seek through kindness and compassion to achieve with you the life that God has planned for us. And I promise to always be your teammate. All right, at this time, Ryan and Pam are going to exchange rings. So these rings that they're about to exchange, they represent the unending love that God has given to you to love each other. This love is eternal and should never change. These rings are a symbol of your love that will last forever. Ryan, take Pam's left hand. earthly possessions. I give you all my earthly possessions. From this moment forward, from this moment forward, may this ring represent God's unending love, represent God's unending love, which He gave me to love you and all His love. This is my pledge to you.
This is my pledge to you.
Of my constant faith.
My constant faith.
And of all your love.
And of all your
love. Okay. This is the one who requires it from me. Okay. All right. We'll be out of here. Ryan.
Ryan.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my life.
I give you my life.
I give you all my earthly possessions.
From this moment forward,
may this ring
represent God's unending love,
which He gave to me
to love you eternally.
This is my pledge to you
of
my constant faith
and my
body and love. Ladies and gentlemen, by the power vested in me, by the state of Maine, the authority of Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Yes.
VIP, check the tag.
I got one of those too.
Perfect. Oh,
okay. Yeah.
Men with ladies?
Men with ladies?
Or man with ladies?
Yeah.
Man with ladies.
How do we want to be?
Oh, boy. Oh, right? Yeah.
Okay. So you guys are going to be where I am.
You want to tell Ryan and Pam anything?
Ryan, love you, buddy.
Yep.
Here.
NRG Entertainment. I want to know right now, where is the energy in this tent? Let me hear you guys. That's what I'm talking about now. I need that same energy as we introduce our wedding party. You guys, let's give a nice round of applause to our parents of the bride, Steve and Margaret Mortensen. Let's keep a nice round of applause going for your parents of the groom. We have Troy and Eileen Lemire. Woo! I want to hear everybody get loud right now for bridesmaid and groomsmen Kylie and Tristan. Keep it going for your maid of honor and best man, Ashley and Ryan. You guys, I want to see everybody on their feet right now. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. Do me a favor and take those napkins off the table and spin them high above your head. And let's give a nice round of applause for Ryan Moravec, Pam, and Ryan Lanier.
But a girl like you, with all of
And the guys who...
How you doing, everybody? I'd like to thank you all for being here to celebrate these two wonderful people, Ryan and Pam, and their decision to come together and spend the rest of their lives with one another. If you don't know me, my name is Ryan McClare, and I met Ryan about 15 years ago. My parents decided to have me shadow Portsmouth Christian Academy. I was 8, and I shadowed the same third grade class Ryan was in. Come the end of that day, I had already caused my bit of trouble, landed 2 kids in the principal's office for being too loud and obnoxious. Thankfully, they couldn't send me there yet, because I didn't go to the school. But decision was still made to send me to PCA. I had plenty of time over the next 9 years to become well acquainted with the office staff and principal. From the first day I started in fourth grade, me and Ryan were instantly friends and have been ever since. And I have to say, one of the biggest privileges of my life has been watching this kid grow from a boy into a strong man of God who has an amazing giving and loving heart. From all the years of knowing Ryan and being friends, I can truly say that I've watched him walk the straight and narrow for almost 15 years. He never got involved in any of the crap, drinking, drugs, and drama that comes with any high school, but he was still friends with everyone, and everyone loved him because he was such a good guy. So Mr. and Mrs. Lemire, thank you for raising your son to be an upright, hardworking, and good man. You seriously have so much to be proud of. Ryan, I want to thank you for being my best friend through the years. The best years of my life and the worst years of my life. Years of Friday night, pool and nachos, skillet concert at Hampton Beach, old Greg and a 30 rack of Bud Light.
Yeah.
Some of the best memories of my life. And I promise when I get off my diet, we're gonna go obliterate some Patty's nachos and play some pool. So thank you for all the good memories we have together, and I can't wait for a lifetime more. Also, thank you for being with me in my worst times, the night that I lost my father. You dropped everything to take care of me. You raced me to the hospital. Be out until 3 in the morning getting my motorcycle on your trailer and bringing it home for me. And then working the longest day I've ever worked the next day, cleaning it with my mom. Because I felt it was what I needed to do to keep my mind off of things. And you were there the whole time. I want you to know that I'm going to be here for you and your wonderful bride. And eventually you guys as family in any situation under any circumstance. Pam, I want to thank you for making my friend so happy, so in love, and taking care of him for so many years. Allowing his dumbass friend to stick around for this long time. I love you. I love you. It's been a privilege to watch your relationship develop over the years, and I cannot wait to see what God has in store for the two of you. I feel you two will be such a blessing to many people. I love you both. Massive congratulations to this beautiful couple. And a toast to Ryan and Pam. May you two have a lifetime of happiness and love together. Cheers.
Woo!
If you'd be so kind of keep the applause going for Ashley, she's also going to say a few words for us.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming out on this beautiful day to celebrate Ryan and Pam's special day. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Ashley. I'm Ryan's younger sister. And it's such a privilege to be here tonight, and I'm so honored to be here as Pam's maid of honor. I should probably stand over here.
You can stand wherever you want. I love it.
So I've already cried a little bit, so hopefully I won't cry again, but we'll see. So Pam has always been the sister that I never had, but I always wanted. And I've never met someone with such a kind soul like Pam has. And the first time I met her, I was 15 years old, and she quickly became a role model in my life and someone that I looked up to and someone who I wanted to be like. Even though I've only known Pam for a few years, I feel like I've known her for a lifetime, and I'm so thankful to have her in my life, my brother's life, and that she's now officially my sister-in-law. And to Ryan, my wonderful older brother, I love you, and I'm so blessed to have shared these past 21 years of my life with you. And I'm so proud to be able to call you my brother. And I've always looked up to you since day one, and I'll continue to do so for the rest of my life. And so congratulations and big love to the beautiful bride and groom, and welcome to the family, Pam.
Mama's loose, mama's out.
Pam and Steve up here.
Sunset prom picture you took together that set this whole day off, and here's the rest of your lives together.
Nice. Good.
Hi Ryan, hi Pam. We're having a great time at your wedding and celebrating your life together. I'm so proud of you both, and I can't wait to see you guys at the pool soon. In the meantime, congratulations. I love you both.
Awesome.
Pamela, congratulations. I am really happy for you, and good luck for your future.
Awesome. Give away. Nice. Cool.
I want to say something, but I don't know what to say.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Yeah, wish you guys the best.
And I'm jealous.
Yep.
And Ryan, if you hurt her, I will come and kill you.
Hi, Pam and Ryan. Thank you for inviting us. We're having a wonderful time at your wedding. Celebrating you two joining your lives together, and we just want you to know that we'll be praying for you guys and supporting you in, as you begin your journey and throughout your life journey. We're so excited, and that's it. I don't have anything.
Anything else?
I just remember Ryan, when we go to his house, he'd be at the top of the hill. And then once he would see us, he would turn around on his bicycle and bike as fast as he could to the house to beat us.
Yep.
I was just thinking about those memories of when he was small last night. So it's so good, and I'm so proud to see him now being a man and having a great wife. I wish him the best.
Awesome. Adam?
Good.
Cool.
Congratulations.
Awesome.
Congratulations.
Kristen, what do you got to say to Ryan and Pam?
Man, good luck. I love both of you. You know? Best of luck. I know you guys are great for each other. God bless.
Ryan and Pam, thanks for having us all out here. It's been a good weekend. I want to congratulate both of you. Proud of you guys. I love you guys. Thank you for letting me be part of your family and part of this ceremony. I wish you guys the best. And congrats, guys. You guys are awesome. So I love you guys. Hey, what do you got to tell Ryan and Pam?
Hi.
Official.
Oh yeah, that nice fourth grade attendance.
Oh yeah.
Yep. Ryan and Pam, being married is a blast. Best wishes to you. Take care. What are you gonna say?
I'm gonna say, first of all, Pam, you know what you're getting into when you get into the Shea family. And good luck, you guys. Love you guys.
Love you both.
Awesome.
Babe, I love you. This was the best day ever. And yeah, let's go have some fun. Awesome.
Side, but Ryan, you gotta remember something very important right now. Happy wife. Happy life.
Make the right choice, man.
And I can't sweep you off of your feet.
Send it, Ryan.
Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till 70. Baby, my heart could still fall out.
Hey guys, very excited for you guys. Love you guys so much. You guys are an amazing, special couple. I'm supposed to give you some special words, but I think the only thing I can say is I love you guys and I'm excited for you. You guys are amazing. Just to see you guys together, how much fun you have, how much you love each other, how much you care for each other is just way beyond anything I've seen of anybody I've done a wedding for lately. So God bless you guys. I love you guys. Have an amazing time together.
Hey guys, Barb, I just want to say that we are so happy you guys got married today and that we've been a part of your special day. Hope you have a wonderful life together and we love you.
So just got done doing the cake thing. I'm gonna go change. I think my dress has grass stains. Out, right? I'm just disgusting. So,
what do you want to tell Ryan?
What I want to tell Ryan is I hope he enjoyed all this because he's never gonna do this again. He's never gonna get married again. I'm never gonna get married again. We're gonna be like old, like crispy things that are all dried out. Yeah. My wedding advice to him is let me win every argument, even if I'm wrong. Don't tell me I'm wrong because I'm not. And basically, I should be in control of the heat of the house.
Yeah.
He's right there. The animals are mine. I don't care what the vow said about like we share our possessions. No, those animals are mine. And I should be able to bring home any animal that I see fit. And I feel like his lifespan will be increased tremendously if he follows those rules.
Good.
Yeah.
All right. Congrats.
Thanks.
And Pam, something on the...
Good luck, buddy. Happy wife is a happy life.
In the living room, and they didn't get to have a first dance. And so a couple weeks ago, my dad and I and Ryan were in the car, and he heard a song on the radio, and he really wanted to dedicate it to Mom. So Mom, if you could come up here, he would like to have his official first dance in front of everybody with you. Surprise! Woo!
Day starts with a coffee. Beautiful, crazy, she can't help but amaze me. The way that she dances, ain't afraid to take chances, and wears her heart on her sleeve. Yeah, she's crazy, but her crazy is beautiful to me.
Join them up on the dance floor for this special moment now.
Done. You guys have fun?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Oh yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I'm like, you know, tell you, just tell me and I'll take care of you. I just don't want you to, you know.
That's it. That concludes it. Right?
We're done.
Boom. We're done.
Boom.
We're done.
Now we're doing that again.
Catching the boat.
Now the work begins.
What work? No, I'm done.
Oh no. You're just starting.
Bye. jump.